Hey guys, welcome back, and here is the Sebae Anemone as it looks today, and it's been actually just about 3 years that I've owned this anemone, and it's the whole time it's been in my 24-gallon Nano Cube, and I thought it would be cool to show you those still images just kind of showing the evolution of this particular anemone. And when I bought it 3 years ago, it came with that cinnamon clownfish already hosted to it. And you can see in those earlier pictures it was maybe like two and a half inches across, and here's how it looks today. I believe it's full grown. It's been this size for the better part of the last year, so I'm not really see it growing anymore, but it's very healthy. I think when it's fully open it's probably 16 to 18 inches across, and it's just a beautiful species. I know there's other more colorful anemones out there that you can purchase for your saltwater tanks. You know, obviously the bubble tip anemones and the rose bubble tip and some of the other carpet anemones have more color than this, but I really like this species. It's done really well in this system, and I'm at 3 years and I don't see any reason why this anemone won't be around for a very long time. So. It's mostly this tan color, but it does have like purple tips on the tentacles. And I'll kind of zoom in, see if I can catch that for you. At night, when I have the actinic blues on, the purple tips show up a little bit better. So that kind of gives you an idea of that. I've always had clownfish hosted to this anemone. Originally, that cinnamon clown. I had a gold bar maroon clown in here for a brief period. Then my pair of Picassos, which were in here for about a year, maybe a year and a half. And now my latest rendition, which is this black saddleback clown. So the other thing I want to show you in this video is I'm going to go ahead and feed this anemone right now. I spot feed this anemone about every 2 to 3 weeks, just a chunk of raw shrimp. And I want to try to show you the rock that this anemone is mounted to, because it's kind of a cool story. I went out and specifically selected this rock to house this anemone, and I'm gonna spot feed it right now, and hopefully it'll retract a little bit and you can get a better look at this rock that this anemone is mounted to. So you guys just saw me spot feed the anemone, and it used to retract a lot more. This thing is just so filled out, it can't even really pull itself in that much, but you can see it has somewhat pulled itself in. It's consuming that food. But I want to kind of show you this rock. This is a really cool piece of live rock. It's got a real nice flat shape to it, and it's kind of concave, like bowl shaped. So it really holds the whole disc part of the anemone really well, and I have it propped up and tilted back, so it gives it really good viewing from the front looking into the tank, but it's also tilted back so the anemone gets really good light. But the coolest part about this rock is there was there's a hole in the middle, maybe about a 2.5-inch hole, and the foot of the anemone is going down through the hole. And I'll show you, if I go down here, so this is behind and underneath the rock, and that is the foot of the anemone. And this thing is just a monster. I mean, even the foot is maybe 4 to 5 inches across. You can kind of see it underneath there too. It's a neat rock. I kind of put this rock here and oh, there goes my lighting, but I'll still continue with this vid. Generally for like an actinic shoot, I would adjust the white balance. I'm not going to do that right now. But anyway, the way this rock kind of comes down and sits on this smaller one, I mean, you get these different arches, and the water flow in this tank is really good. I got water moving all the way around this anemone, and even behind these rocks where the foot is, there's pretty good water movement. So I think it keeps the anemone happy, and my whole point was to get this rock and have the anemone kind of plant itself like this with its foot through that hole so it would stay put. And it always has. It used to retract a lot more, and its tentacles would nearly go all the way into the hole. And it was really cool. You just see a few of the tips of the tentacles sticking out of the hole. But now this thing is pretty good size. That's about as much as it retracts in. But it's a really cool setup. I thought I'd show you guys. I don't think anyone watching my videos really realized that the anemone, the foot, was going through this rock like that. So I find it pretty cool. And that's it for this video. I'll talk to you guys soon.